Time moves forward. This is sometimes described as time's arrow. We move from a past towards a future. We know we are entering into the unknowable.
We wish we didn't know it. We like it when we don't.
Walk down the street. sky's grey as I get out of the underground.
The sky's cold as I get out of the underground.
The sky's wet as I get out of the underground.
The sky's screaming as I get out of the underground.
The sky's huge as I get out of the underground.
The sky sings as I get out of the underground.
The sky whispers my name.
The sky catches fire.
The sky freezes into a huge block of ice.
The sky blows into my eyes.
And then, suddenly, as if by magic, I start noticing all these men. It's like men everywhere, and they're the most beautiful men I've ever seen in my whole life, and they all gather together in one block at one time. And all of them so beautiful, and they all just wash their hair. And I want to take a gun. I want to own their shops. I want to watch them take their shoes off at the end of the day. And all of them smell so beautiful, like they're made of glass and fire.
Turn into a coffee shop. Sit at the window. Drink a large cup of hot chocolate, which is actually so large that it burns your lips.
I want one more time to be absolutely in the moment. I know that I can't, but I want to so very much. You moved towards me. You knew exactly where you wanted to go without even having to tell me. I lay down. I open myself up to you completely. I knew exactly that you were going to do that.
There are two principal reasons why, even in the throes of orgasm, that it is impossible to stop the inexorable movement forward of time's arrow.
The first principal reason is because sexuality is as charged with swaths of memory and past as any other experience.
Sometimes this is comparative. The fuck is much better than the last time she fucked her husband.
Or she preferred it when he stuck his tongue in her ass than when he put his finger up her.
Quite.
I wasn't even looking at you. Maybe it'll be him. Maybe it'll be the Italian boy who's serving everybody their drinks and their sandwiches and rested my waffle on the rim of my cup. Maybe it'll be the man who works next door shop. Maybe it'll be a complete stranger. Maybe I'll try to go on Facebook and try to contact my old friend. Maybe it will be the man who let me down off the train as he climbed onto it and smiled as he caught my eye. Maybe it'll be the man, a young man, who I see out of my window every morning taking his son to school. No, he looks far too young to have a child. Maybe it'll be a man I meet on the internet. Maybe a man who comes around from a postal delivery service. Come in here. Come with me. Touch my hand. Touch my face. Smell my hair. Kiss my cheek. Kiss my eyelids. Lick. drop a teacup onto a hard floor. It breaks.
The smash of the cup is defined by how high she held it.
How much tea was in the cup?
How it was made.
At what angle it hit the floor?
What the floor was made of.
All these forces work together to create the form of a smashed cup and the puddle of tea on the floor.
It is atomically possible, but astronomically improbable, that these forces could combine together to take those elements.
The smashed cup and the spilled tea.
And propel them back together to form a cup of tea in her hand.
Like that.
And the two of them went like...
Are you okay?
Are you burned?
Did I burn you? Look at me. Look into my eyes. He looks at me. I've never had that before. It was like... I liked it. I did. It was like... He was going into another world or something. He looks right into my eyes. And if I had to say the difference between what I've got from him at that precise moment and what I've got from you, it will be that. He holds my gaze. He looks right into my eyes. And I think the word might be forgiveness. We look away from each other. Quickly, startled, smiling, terrified. Turn, walk away, that's all. I can't
hear the words on the radio.
I can't
hear the music that they're playing.
I can't
hear the sounds on the telephone.
I can't
hear my footsteps as I walk out of the door.
I can't
hear the cars that pass me on the street.
I can't
hear the sound of the planes in the sky.
Have you ever found yourself thinking I could just jump?
It is this consciousness that leads us to try to live with empathy as we recognize it within one another.
It is this consciousness that led to democracy and the death camp, to the explorations of the outer limits of our galaxy, and the possibility of nuclear war.
Your eyes. You're sitting there and you're trying to look all cool and defined, but you look tired. I feel myself moving towards him. I move towards him.